The charm of Hammerin Hero is undeniable, especially if you love some classic anime-style visuals. I mean, the box art alone had me sold. That's pretty much the reason why I bought the game. The unique visual charm, however, doesn't hold up when actually getting down to play it, unfortunately. There really aren't any glaring issues, except maybe for those few instances when the frame rate dips rather severely, but the overall mechanics and the general design is just it's just that it's totally underwhelming. The biggest problem is just with the game's flow, which is far too slow considering that it's a side-scrolling platformer. Every single action feels kind of sluggish and slow. I wouldn't go so far as to say that everything feels like it is in slow motion, but that's not too far from the truth, actually. Jumps feel delayed, and regular attack animations take a little bit of waiting time to finish. So swinging a baseball bat is like, it's that little delay. It just feels so sluggish for some reason. And the heavy attacks that throw enemies out from the screen are even slower. Thus, while the levels are charming to look at, and the boss fights really interesting, the actual gameplay is not that engaging because you're stuck with this slow pace throughout the whole game. Even with the ability to change jobs, the game still kind of is boring. And these jobs include like sushi chef, baseball slugger, DJ, man in black, comedian, of all kind of jobs. There's, which are really, but the jobs, while cool looking, they're really only for aesthetics. They don't really change much the gameplay. So that's it's just there to kind of be like, oh wow, it's really cool that I'm throwing, DJ discs at people as my weapon, or throwing fish as a sushi chef as weapons or something. It's just cool and funny to look at, but doesn't really change the gameplay. The slow feel of the game is definitely intentional though, because some bosses can be beaten by utilizing or exploiting this aspect of the game. On the amusement park level where you fight a floating mechanical device on top of a Ferris wheel, standing on the edge of the Ferris wheel and repeatedly button mashing the regular attack is all it takes to beat the level because the bosses are deliberately designed to be slow as well. So you just get them stuck in that attack animation, go and you'll beat the boss just like that. The tanker ship on the coast gives you long hints of when it's going to attack you, so you can dodge it, although the slow movements on your character can result in the game's continued screen rather easily. So in that level, the boss has these humongous containers, right? There's two containers, and it falls down on you. If you get squeezed under that container, it's automatic game over. But the chances of that is pretty slim, because when it's about to fall down, it like blinks, 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 blinks. It just takes really long time. It's almost that the game designer is kind of like, all right, we're going to deliberately design this game to be extremely slow paced. So let's accommodate that with even the boss battles that are just slow moving. So the pacing of the game, not necessarily like the actual pacing of presentation, but just the entire pace, as in the gameplay flow, is just slow. And then there's the underwater level, which makes things even worse, because there the motion is slowed down to make it feel like you're underwater. So it really drops down to the speed of a crawl. Oh man, not to mention the occasional drops of frame rate, especially in that level. So not only is it slower than slow, you're getting frame rate stutters and lags. So there are definitely, I mean, some interesting things to look to in this game, especially the crazy ghost level. That's a really fun level, and the space combat sequence at the very end of the game, and the really catchy music that plays in the end credits. But it's honestly, to be fair, it's not much of a compensation considering just how badly this game plays and how ridiculous the character dialogues and the story of this game is. The ending to the game is one of the biggest what the F moment ever. Even compared to other crazy odd 2D platformers. Maybe that's the reason why you might want to play this game, just to experience that odd what the fuck moment. But, that's why, as charming as Hammerin Hero may seem, or maybe even be, it actually is far too slow and far too dull. The fact that this game can be beaten in under 2 hours is yet another reason to deeply regret the purchase.